For me, I like the fact that he was asking questions because he started like, okay, what is the number of population in America? He said 320. So how many are you trying to reach? And I said 1 million for you. He said that's how I said 50 billion. He said 50 million in one place. I said no, one for each state. So it was helping me to break it down that makes more sense. Then he asked, what tool are you going to use for each one? I said the NGO is okay. How many spheres? I mean, he was just asking so many questions that was provoking me. To help me better.
Very good. Yeah, that really helps you break it down, right?
Okay, adding to what they said, somebody else is also saying.
That is good.
Yeah, okay, Pastor, for me now, I can see I'm a leader. It really helped me to see that I'm a political leader, that I can influence the poor, that are below, and then also get to the public, and then even touch those who are in authority. And he led me to see how I can do it, and I saw all at once, I saw that, I'm becoming a political leader. He says, yes, you will become. And so he showed me to start an NGO, like you have assigned us to do, and then feed the poor, and then join the social lobby. And then from there, I have to connect to other NGOs to become partners with them. And then I should always tell them my vision. And then even start with training centers. And then he asked me, what am I doing now to touch the people? And then I told him, I'm training people. I already did history makers with 19 people. He says, what stopped you from doing more? So go on and do more and train them
so that
you make it.
So what he was doing with you is that he was giving you people personal coaching, personal consulting.
The suggestion I wanted to make is, if it's possible, like make it
a chat.
No, like a model, whereby like the teacher will come, maybe half an hour, he teaches the theory, then half an hour, I give it to him practically, that the remaining 1 hour, he begins to work with
correct you. So that just like this guy did, eh?
Yes. So that at the end, you see your work, what you have done, and how to find it.
Did you hear that? You have to write that down. Okay. What was the third group? You are the second that became third.
The first shall be the last, and the last shall be the first.
We have the governor with us.
You know, there was something he said, not specifically about the systems, but it was about the mission. He said the mission of Jesus was saving people, and your mission should be the same as Jesus' mission. You know, that just to put another aspect on systems altogether, that basically all the systems, the ultimate aim of the whole thing is saving people. I also think it was so good. I got so much yesterday from Alina. He built very nicely for me in understanding things, the processes, and you know, the strategies, the four P's he gave us, which was also about really saving souls, really just blessed me and has given me, you know, I could just see it. I've tried to do those things before, but the way he systematized it and the way I can see I can put that system in. Even when he broke up the personal life systems, all the different systems just in your own personal life, I think my life is going to be transformed.
One thing I really enjoyed was when he focused on the need to build personal systems for personal growth, so that you know you can find that you can create many segments of systems, and interestingly at the end when he just also shared briefly about his experience with identifying the different characteristics or different character types of his children, and how that would then help him design each system. So I could see that really, at the end of the day, if you can deal with the issue of systems, you can free up time to do so much more. So systems are the heart of productivity.
So now that's why I'm so free. Eh?
Yeah. And he made that point as well, that at the end of the day, so the system's like the brain, you can think it through and how everything works. There's predictability, and you can then be so much more productive. I think that's something I really got out of.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Yeah.
Okay, I'm very glad that I got this one at the end. No, seriously, because what he did for me was put everything together. The life plan and the system building, different things that I have done. Already. I have started, but I know when I go back, I have to finalize it, review it. And I want to make sure that, you know, the danger when you get down in one direction is to forget the whole picture at the end, you know. So you just get down the details in one direction and you forget that there are two others or many others that you have to put together. So it was very good when you talked about the master system that you have to put at the end to make sure you have everything together, that you don't miss the goal at the end of what you want to do. And also one thing that I received was, I would say the biggest strength of him is how to maximize the potential of his leaders. That's what I saw. For example, he told us that even the presentation, he didn't do it himself. He assigned his leaders to create the presentation. And for me, personally, it's a challenge. It's something I have to remind myself continually. Just an example. I was telling somebody that yesterday I had to repent because a few days ago you asked me, like, what are you targeting the whole of Switzerland? And I told you it's only the French speaking, because I was thinking about me. I don't speak the other languages, right? And I currently in my sphere of influence, I
want just disciple people.
Yeah, only French speaking people. But actually, yes, you can reach out to the other
disciple people.
Yes.
And then your disciples.
Absolutely. So, I mean, for me, that
you got it. You got it.
Thank you.
Very good.
Yeah, he broke down. The three of them brought different strengths of understanding to systems. Because you think they are not all talking about systems, but time is complemented one another. But he brought them things, you know, they came before that for us. He took process, for instance. So what is process? I mean,
process. What is process? That is good. That is
so good. It brought a fresh understanding of process on its own. You know, and the same thing with systems, he talked about three kinds of systems. So he brought a new understanding to systems. So his own tool was, you know, very practical. And when I first hand that his system is thousands of pages. So I said, I said to myself, the person next to me, I said, he has a computer brain. But then when he now came up and said he didn't do this thing, you know, himself, he only discipled things.
That is smart.
I said to myself, wow. Because, I mean, before now, I've been planning on how I would go on personal retreat, put all these things together, and then bring my leaders together and change them on how to run it. And now I know that that's not the way to go. You know, it's better I bring them together, you know, train them, disciple them, and let them develop this thing. And they will do it like
yourself. Yeah, you know the way I do it? Is that I will bring them together, teach them, show them how to do it, then give them a homework. So next week when they come back, or next month, they must have designed their own, how they understand it. Then they begin to present it, and I begin to connect them. So then I see the strength of this one here, the weakness of this one here. Then they add, I had them, then they see, everybody see. And that's how they, I develop them. But I work on them like that for 9 months.
Yeah, I started like that. Then after 3 months, I saw that many of them were not,
they're not catching it.
Doing it the way. So in this retreat, I was making up my mind, and
I
was just going to design all of these things.
Yeah, but if you can do it, it will still be a standard. It's still good. Then they will still give them the assignment then. Because even if only one of them will catch it, then that one will become your main guy on system later on. So then he will be, just be giving direction. But it's important for you to know what you need, to know how to do the system, so that when you give him now, you can collect him later on.
Yeah, I could see that. I'm glad also that he came last, because he put everything together, and he did that on purpose, because you could see also he's a man of detail. Because he showed us, they said, how to do a process in the detail parts of it. He also worked on a 4P, which is a system of getting information of what you want. For example, if you want how to get people into the system, how you pursue them until each one of them reach the goal. So basically, that was a canva you can use on every subsystem that you have, and that will allow you to get all the details that you need for your system. But on the other hand, as she pointed out, he stressed that each one mission is a mission of Jesus. You know, then that shows that he was a man of vision, because it's easy to explain to people who are coming to you that, you know, if you're going to do the mission of Jesus, this is the tool that you're going to use to get there. That was really, that was powerful. And then he showed how all the systems that you need, you need to put them together in three directions. One is your personal development system. The second one is raising sons.
That is good.
And then put them together. If you can develop yourself and then raise sons, then whatever you need to achieve, you will achieve it.
Brilliant, brilliant.
Let's talk about the mission of Jesus, which also, I mean, attracted my attention, because now I understand that whatever mission that I'm having is not supposed to be away from the mission of Jesus, which is salvation. And again, we draw unto us A, point A and B, that is A, that's where we are, and then B, that's where we're going, that is the final destination, that is our vision. And at the same time, he draw the processes, he gave us the processes as to how to go.
You can pick more than one, or don't just pick one by one. So go ahead and...
Yeah, and then even in the process,
as many as you want.
Even in the processes, he told us as to what are the actual processes that are involved. That is what is that you're going to do, and then where are you going to do this, and when, who is going to be responsible, the reports that are there, and the results. So that's also at least filled the gap for me at that particular process. And at the same time, I realized that, I mean, the three of them, as they're presenting, they've been complimenting each other. I mean, maybe if there is something that you happen not to hear to the other one, at least you happen to catch.
So that was a good idea, that we made all of them supplement each other, right?
Thank you. As Pastor has mentioned, I noted he's a person of detail. And I realized that some of our interventions fail because we just look here on the surface and we don't go to the details, which are the basics. And another thing which I really liked in his presentation, he gave an example. It's not only about putting a system and sending it out there to work. He really acknowledges that the only one who can make it work is God, because he gave an example of the prayer cards. So if I am a member or leader of his church and I put 10 people who I need to reach out in that month, even before I go to them, I need to start praying to them, which it might look small, but it has very much impact, because by the time I go to speak to that person, heavens has already opened.
Amen. Amen.
And I thought as to why, if somebody is really doing that, why shouldn't we see growth? You see, we can put systems, but if we don't acknowledge that it's God who is going to work it out, we might end up being frustrated. And he went even as much as saying, before I got married, I prayed concerning my children. I say, God, some of us, you wait until God, now can you show the man? You've not even spoken to God concerning the kind of man you desire, and a man shows, before you realize, you spend the rest of your life praying out the things you don't want. I thought that was something very significant. Yeah, better pray to get something which is, rather than just get anything, and then you spend the rest of the time praying out.
One thing I thought was just the bringing together of the whole picture, and I just likened it to some of the things that we learn in school and in the industry, that the goal of every individual in an organization is tied into the overall mission of a company. You can't go out of it, irrespective of the department you are. You have to align with the global picture of the organization, which is Jesus, which I never knew before.
Wow, that is good. That is good.
Everything, every process I build, everything I want to achieve in life, I'm have a goal. I want to be a good Christian. Your central truth, your central goal must go back to Him.
Very good.
Must go back to Him. And which that's what we do in operational strategy, that is global vision. When you can scale it down, individual department might have their own, my own goals, but everything has to go back to
Jesus,
to the company goal. So now, whatever spheres I want to go, it has to be Him. Then another thing he did was the breaking down of the regions. If I turn tomorrow that I want to be maybe a governor of my state or whatever, just break it down. Raise specific leaders for each region.
Very good.
Then my work is finished.
Yes.
And those who just produce leaders and everything else.
Brilliant.
And it has actually broken everything down. So you don't need to belabor yourself, I'm not this, I'm not that. Raise each leader from every local government or every ward. Be working with them and everything is set.
So we could actually design consulting projects for business and people and for political people all over the world.
Well, bringing the spiritual and the natural together. So, and he demonstrated it by his own life, like she was saying, in terms of his praying even before. He also knew about his children before he got married, which I thought that was phenomenal. I mean, I've heard people talk about men in particular, talk about praying for the wife, but I think you may be one of the first that I've heard to say that you also sought the Lord to know how many children you need to be so I can reach to that. But he did go high level.
and then you just broke the pieces down very clearly, and then went underneath to give you specific steps. And I thought that was helpful. He also had illustrations at the part of that, which I think brought a little bit more light to it. So when we leave here, we have some tangible examples that we can at least refer to. And he also showed the framework, but again, he broke the pieces down, and that was great. Thank you.
Brilliant.
Very grateful to God, for actually really making somebody like me come and be with geniuses like them, for no cost, at no cost. And what people in the world are actually struggling, and they pay thousands and thousands of pounds. This is what we are listening to.
You are right. That one, on that one, you are very right.
Yeah. Because I saw how, the monolith, the concept of it, was to me, it was mind-blowing. By the time it started explaining, I quickly had to search what monolith was, and I found that it was a stone.
You are previously by your statue, so that it's like the ready surface stone.
Yeah, then I found out that rock, is actually representing Jesus Christ as well. And then when it now started, what caught me was the vision. How he now said that you have to go from the end of the vision and you walk your way back to the beginning of the vision. And then he tied everything up. So it made me see, for me, I'm very pictorial. So it made me see the way I described it was like a beat, and that Jesus Christ was the string that was holding all the beads together. So not only that did I see the framework of the wheel, I now saw all the things that would go inside the process, that would go inside the beads. And then when he now said about his personal life, and then how he ties all that into all the other systems that he uses, that for me, I wanted to get that, because I wanted to come before I came, I didn't really see how I could get all the things that I have to do. It was mind-blowing for me how I 24 hours could be enough, or even a month could be enough for all the projects that I had to do. And I was almost becoming,
the system.
But then I was almost becoming not being able to sleep. But then he now said it's the system. When you put the system in place, then you'll be able to do so many things.
Very good. Well, to that devil is to parle pas sleep me, but I'm sure I need to tell you. Excellent. Well, do you all think that, these seminars and these workshops have helped you? Pastor Kharide, it's for you, I was saying they should bring this.
Thank you, sir. I'll take you.
Okay. Well, you can get more. So do you all think that these seminars have really opened your eyes to a large extent, no? Yeah? Have you been enraged a lot better than before you came?
I don't think you really mean that question. It's been life transformed.
No, we designed it to do that.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it had done that.
More. It has achieved more. By your question, it has achieved more than that. So we've not just gained in terms of being different from where we came. It has been a transformative experience, completely transformative.
So you didn't expect as much?
Well, anytime we come, it's so transformative. So I don't know, I would not say.
You couldn't gauge the expectation because you had never been there before.
Yeah. Yeah.
And stage 1, it was like an introduction telling us what to go out to do.
What is possible.
So like as we went out and tried and had some failures and
some failures, some success,
coming back to stage 2, now highlighting what went wrong and how to address that and how to be able to be more effective. So it really did everything that it was designed to do. I didn't get what I expected. I will say that I can see clearly some of the mistakes, some of the things that I didn't do right that I need to go back and correct.
Now you have the teachers here. Welcome them. Yeah. Now you all have the opportunity to throw questions to all of us and we can all interact. This is the idea of this whole thing. You've interacted with me a lot more, but we can all of us sit down together, maybe concerning your own ideas, concerning your own dreams, concerning how we could help you, or whatever you want to find out, or concerning us, or Ukraine, or what you've heard. This is the only last session we'll be able to really interact like this. Tomorrow you're all going. So be free.
One thing that everybody's been seeing as they've been doing their systems, I think it was my sister that said it yesterday, that they don't duplicate what's already there. Like, for example, all the trainings, everyone gets people, but they put them into a system of training, and they don't have to make up new systems of training. Those trainings are always there, like the ABC, the, you know, the minister's training and all that. So my question is that training available for people like us? Because we all go back, and if we all have to develop our own trainings, you know, we get all these leaders, we process them all, but they've got a ready-made structure of training to put them into. What happens about that issue of the training, you know, your ABC and these things? Is that available in English? Because they've all said that they don't duplicate their own, they just use
the church. Yes, I think we have to a large extent, not in the best of English, but we have the ABC in English. But you have to talk to Luda about it. I think Luda is somewhere here, right?
Yes.
Yeah, Luda.
Pastor Sunday, we have it. I have the ABC developing your potential. We got it on our previous visit to Ukraine, so we can make that. We have it. You've already released this to us.
Okay.
Especially developing your potential.
Okay, question, will I make it available to you?
Yes.
Yes, at the cost of $500 each.
Yeah, because that's what he paid, that's what people paid, right? No,
who said why?
No, it was $400 each.
We contributed to have these things translated.
Yes, yes.
But why? You're still hunting. We're still hunting for finished products.
Yes.
Whatever will cost you, get it. But anyway, we'll discuss whether that'll be something.
Maybe you need to pay a little bit for it.
Yeah.
Because they paid for what they got. So maybe you need to pay a little bit.
So that's why the church giving is 1%. That's a share.
Amen. Just in response to what...
Lauren.
Just in response to what you said and what was said here, maybe you've done this already, but at the same time, nothing works like sitting down and crunching your own numbers, building something, even as an example to take a few people through, because we had nothing. I had nothing when I went home. And we had to just build a few that were a little smaller and just introduce it like that. And they got it on a smaller scale, which opened them up to the system of 10,000 being believable for them. Maybe you've done that already, I don't know.
No, she's talking about
the materials. She's to train them in systems?
Sorry, it's not training them in systems, Derek. It's the actual, it's the spiritual content, especially that one, developing your
position. The stages, the stages.
Because trying to shift the church into that different mindset. Now, we could develop something like that as well, but it would be good to see what is it that has produced the quality of believers.
We answered. You get it. Go to the next one. Don't spend too much time. All right. What do you want to do with us? What do you want to know before you go back to your country?
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you want to take people to Africa. Maybe we need to discuss a little bit of that.
Yes, I must confess. I apologize. I've spoken more often these 2-3 days than I normally do. That's just to tell you how excited I am. But please forgive me. Pastor Sunday, tell me if this is right or wrong. These systems we've learned, and also we are connecting to our passion. If you learn to articulate that passion with a good system, That material is enough to give you a PhD in any school.
Definitely.
Are you listening?
Definitely.
So
several PhDs.
Exactly. So don't just go to build system. Be smart. Go and build it in somebody's school. And then they give you a PhD degree for that. Not only that, you know, they'll be so impressed because they've never seen it before.
They will want to use it for their schools.
Not only that, you're going to connect to a network within that school that you will use later. So, and Pasonbe, is that not the secret behind the reason of 300 PhDs?
Yes. Even that one is on lower scale. The 300 PhD people I want to graduate in 1 year, they come from my lower group. I have home group leaders, my home group people. They are coming from there. And they have maybe only 10% of what I gave this one. And one of them was in PhD, doing PhD when I was training them. After 6 months of 1 year of working with them, she just went and finished her PhD, and she had been trying to finish it for 3 years. She couldn't do it. She just, because she said she discovered that every single month of working with Pastor Sunday, the material she needed to do work with was much more than all her 3 years she has been trying to do PhD. Every month was doing a PhD standard project. So she just went and finished it up. She just said, my God. She said she began to weep and say, why did I use my time doing 3 years in those PhD programs? In Pastor Sunday, something took me through that program in 1 month. And every month another program, anywhere on that program. And that is not even their own stage. That is the one I did lower, much lower. It is with those lower group that I have 300 PhD coming in 1 year. I mean, in the medicine, 2 years.
Just real life example. I'm actually in school as I'm here.
Yes. Okay.
For the PhD program.
PhD program.
My roommate. So while I'm doing the assignment here, I have to do some assignments.
Good.
But the good thing is that what we're doing here, I'm supposed to analyze my organization, which is the church, on systemic issues.
Wow.
So I just translated what I was doing in HLT and submitted it.
That's what I'm talking about. Many of us will go through this exercise. You just come up with a piece of paper. You need to talk like on Sunday. But those that are smart, at the end of it, they will even have 2 or 3 degrees. Just by being strategic.
Those are already PhD programs we are taking you through. All right. Anybody say anything? Anything you want to consider? If the students can't talk, maybe the teachers want to say something.
Ну, хорошо.
Я a little bit late. You are just starting up. Okay, go ahead.
If I need some training, can I come?
Of course. Only you must tell us what so that we could know who to hook you up with. Depends on what she wants.
Can we have the trainings that are done emailed to us so that we can make decision
which
one we want to come? She said, can she
name anything you want to do. Anything you want to do, we'll give you the training for it. Okay?
How many modules do you have? This is our second.
Yes, you have one. You have one more. The third stage. That will be the complete. No, not the complete program. The stage. The graduation. Then after that graduation, you have another one, which is training.
It's an entry-level graduation.
No, no, which is training the trainers. Which is when we're going to give you all the package. And we may give you the certificate to go and train others. So you are finished the program. But not just finishing the program. After finishing the program, that's the third stage, is the last phase. Then there is another one when we will train you as a teacher, no, as a coach. So we'll train you in that one, the practical things more. How to organize, how to put things together, how to develop your team, your leaders, how to go to the conference, how to do it for believers, for unbelievers, for businesses, for secular people, as a consultant, and then you're going to get a paper for it. So you can say, one more stage if you just want to finish the program. But if you want to get a certificate and be licensed, you can say two more stages.
Number one, do we have dates for
no.
So that we can plan?
No, you don't have this. You don't have this. That might come up not next year. That might come up the year after. Yes.
Really? 2013?
Yeah. Because you have a lot to do between now and then.
Well, that's true.
And we are going to give you enough time to prove to us that all these things we've given you, that you have produced results in them. So you are going to submit all your results, all your systems to us. We are going to, every month, we are going to be giving you assignments. And you have to prove to us that you are responsible enough to be invited for the next. All right. Алена, вот это что?
Да. Я хотела бы сказать всем спасибо.
I would like to thank each one of you.
Что эти три дня я была с вами.
It was a pleasure for me to spend these three days with you.
И точно так же от вас я много почерпнула для себя.
And you said that you learned a lot from us, but I want to say that I also learned a lot from you.
Спасибо вам большое.
Thank you so much.
И хочу еще сказать, что я увидела, то, чего не видела раньше, может быть, пастор Сандей.
You know, I also would like to share some of my observations. You know, I saw some things in Pastor Sandei that I didn't see in him before.
Мы постоянно слышим, что пастор работает не только с нами, но и на другие страны.
We always hear that pastor works not only with us, Ukrainian leaders, but with leaders from other countries as well.
И я очень понимаю, что скоро придет время, когда пастор будет больше ездить.
And I do understand that very soon time will come when pastor will travel again a lot.
И вы являетесь большим благословением для посольства Божьего.
And you are a huge blessing for the embassy of God as well.
Вы тот фундамент, который и будет дальше распространять видение и цели посольства Божьего по всему миру.
You are a foundation that will spread vision and goals of the embassy of God to the whole world.
И когда ты видишь, то есть реально это присутствуют все страны, которые вы представляете.
So I don't see just you as a persons here. I see like you representing your countries here.
И реально это и есть работа системы, о которой мы говорили все эти три дня.
And this is actually a system in action.
И как и нам, так и вам очень сильно повезло, что мы встретили такого человека.
And I know that you and we are very lucky to meet such a person as Pastor Sandei.
И сейчас я еще что-то увидела, то, чего не видела раньше.
You know, I saw something these days, something that I couldn't see before.
Что те дары, которые мы имеем,
that the gifts that we have,
оказывается, мы действительно безответственно относимся, если мы их не переводим и не преобразуем в продукт.
I realized that God gave us gifts, and it's irresponsibility from my side, for example, if I will not make it a product. If I will not translate those materials and make it like marketable product.
Поэтому я, например, приняла решение, что я это буду делать.
So, for example, I made a decision that I will do that.
И материалы, которые есть у меня, темы лидерских школ, и я это действительно превращу в продукт, который переведу на английский язык.
So materials that I have, leader schools that I have, I will transfer it into the product and I will translate it into English language.
Спасибо вам большое.
So thank you so much.
Somebody was saying that yesterday, right? That she should, yes.
Yeah.
Write a book.
Yeah.
I was saying that we should try to write a book on systems.
Because they get used to this. The reason why we don't do it here in Ukraine is because they see all of them know how to do it. So they are thinking, you know, why should pastor is teaching everybody? Who will I write it for? All the other people are teaching their own people. You know, that everybody knows it.
Yeah. I mean, having gone through the three of them now, I'm even thinking they can form a team. And if they can all come together and author a book on systems, everybody specializing in his own. Yes, and give different case studies, and then develop a handbook.
Или отдельно, или вместе, и разработать потом практическое рабочее тетрадь, пособие.
And also design, you know, different kind of seminars.
И каждый из них может сделать различные семинары.
And design a website for it.
И сделать для этих семинаров, для развития этой книги специальные веб-сайты, на которых тоже учитесь.
I believe that you make much more impact on people all over the world.
Я верю, что таким образом они смогут гораздо больше повлиять на людей в мире.
And you will
свои знания.
And you will derive tremendous economic gain.
And what?
Economic gain, financial.
И они смогут также
много для себя зарабатывать.
Работа,
which is hedgehog, according to Jim Collins.
Это как
passion, what you are best at doing.
Ваша страсть, то, что вы делаете, ваши материалы, это сможет превратиться в продукт, вы сможете тоже заработать деньги на этом.
Thank you. Будем делать.
So that you can build an enduring company, a company that will last a long time.
Можете создать свою компанию, которая будет заниматься тем, что учить системы. Эта компания может очень успешно работать многие годы.
За вами. Да, поэтому я и говорю, что надо увидеть что-то сравнение, чтобы начать ценить то, что ты имеешь.
That's what I said. You first have to compare what you have with what others have to be able to value what you have.
Yeah, because with them you are just thinking this is normal. That's the biggest problem with the embassy of God.
Самая большая проблема с посольством Божьим.
They see themselves, they see what they have, and they think everybody else knows it.
like their leader.
Yeah, I like their leader, right?
Leader,
yeah, so he cleared it, sir.
Вы сказали, что вы научились у нас тоже много. Мне хотелось бы узнать, что вы в нас увидели, и тоже хотелось бы ваши отзывы о нас как о студентах.
А, хорошо. Ну, первое, что.
Наболталось, что не только вы у меня учились, я тут у вас много чего.
Так а что наболталось?
Вот тебе надо защищать.
Нет, так я все понимаю.
Это же хотела делать им приятное, да тебе придется защищать.
Нет, я говорила правду.
Украдут ее у нас, украдут.
Во-первых, мне понравилось конструктивизм вопросов.
So I like the way you ask questions. Your questions were practical, not just theoretical in general.
Второе, это в основном вопросы задавались такие, вы действительно хотели что-то узнать.
So from your questions I saw that you really want to know something in order to apply it.
У нас обычно задаются вопросы часто не для того, чтобы получить ответы, а для того, чтобы задать вопрос.
Because often people ask questions not in order to get an answer, just in order to ask.
И я увидела, что надо учить людей задавать вопросы.
I realized that we need to teach people to ask questions, to ask right questions.
Вот. Следующее, что я увидела, что вы, наверное, больше нашего вникаете в детали.
I also realized that probably you people go into details more than our people.
То есть вы останавливаете и задаете вопрос.
So because during my presentation you stopped me, you asked specific questions.
Следующее, то, что отличает опять-таки нас от вас, это вы не боитесь сказать, что вы что-то не знаете.
The next thing that is different between our people and you is that you are not afraid to say that you don't know something.
И, конечно, вы более свободны, раскрепощены.
So you are much more like free than our people. You don't think like what others will think of me. If you have a question, you ask question.
И когда я задавала какие у вас вопросы, какие у вас проблемы?
And when I asked you what challenges, what problems do you have in building or applying systems?
Вы говорили, то есть у меня нет системы, или я, ну то есть то, что есть на самом деле.
You openly said, some of you openly said, I do not have system yet, and I do not understand what is a system yet, or I mean some of you. So our people would maybe make different stories.
И эти я.
Oh, people will just keep quiet, which means you are not Europeans, which is very good.
Она их по одному спрашивала всех.
Я по одному спрашивала. И я это для себя взяла для того, чтобы ну больше работать с людьми именно вот в таком, то есть добиваться правды, добиваться истинного положения, то есть что все-таки есть на самом деле, а не то, что они хотят сказать.
So I like you as a student, and I realize that I have to work with my people the same way. So for them to be the same open to say what they don't understand and what is the real situation. Not just, because sometimes people just say what you expect to hear, but you people say what is the reality, the real picture.
И, ну, и, конечно, это то, что я сказала, это то, что я все-таки увидела по-другому обстоятельства, вернее, будущее посольства Божьего.
And as I said, I saw the future of the embassy of God in a new way.
Мы привыкли, что пастор здесь.
Because we are used to have Pastor Sandy here.
И он уже здесь 2 года.
It's obvious for us, you know, pastor is here and he is here for 2 years.
They just see Pastor Sandy as our pastor. Normally, they just look at Pastor Sandy as our pastor, so they don't know that. No, I'm just from the European values. They don't see me normally as that I'm still working on some other people apart from, you know, I belong here. That's, and that is the challenge we have with the church on Sunday, when 90% of the people are not going for the church. He's our pastor, you know, we have him. He's, they don't know that some people are interested in taking him, or in, you know, that there's a lot of people who are laying a demand on him. They just think, we have, he's our pastor, we are gay, we are good. That's what she's realizing now, because if these people are coming to our territory to get over here. You get the idea, she, right?
Yeah, Вот. И я увидела реально, что скоро пастор начнет ездить.
And I realized that soon pastor will start traveling again.
И что ваши страны нуждаются точно так же в нем, как и мы.
And that your countries need him the same as our country needs him.
И я тоже увидела, что, наверное, надо собирать свои чемоданы. Ну да, да.
And I realized that I have to pack to also travel.
She is also realizing that I know something I could offer people too. Because she was thinking, you know, I just know what Pastor gave me. I'm just okay. I'm just normal. But now, because you people are asking her all these questions, you are learning from her. She's realizing, oh, maybe I need to begin to travel to teach other people too in other places.
Yeah, absolutely.
Даже может быть не то, что учить, но что-то делать тоже для мира.
And not only teach, but do something for the world.
So she has potential to give to the world.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
То есть мы тогда будем плохие ученики, если мы здесь останемся и будем ждать, пока, ну, пастор будет ездить.
Because we will be a bad students if we will just stay in Ukraine and wait for pastor to come back from his traveling.
И я, может быть, повторюсь, но для меня это важно.
Maybe I repeat myself, but that is important for me.
Что оказывается во мне есть больше, чем я думала.
I realized I have more potential, much more than I used to think of myself.
И вот вы мне помогли в какой-то степени сделать переоценку себя.
So you helped me to re-evaluate what we have, what we learned from Pastor, what we have to give to the world.
И, возможно, помогли мне перейти на следующий уровень.
So you probably helped me to go to the next level.
That's our major challenge. Yeah.
Pastor,
is she the one that...
You understand what I said?
No.
Good, good.
Paul will tell me, so... He will.
He didn't, yeah, he was distracted.
Oh, okay. That lets you know. All right, Pastor, I just...
The original. Okay.
Is she the one that you said?
I said, you are just cute like that. I'm telling her to pay attention to a black beauty.
You see. You're pretty as well.
So, is she the one that you were saying yesterday? Pastor, I'm asking you because it's for her. Is she the one you said that she initially had problems with the system then, but after a while?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So, проблема с системой, мы не могли понять, зачем они вообще нужны. Абсолютно. Был для нее вообще работать, а теперь вы один из лучших.
All right. I would like her to share with me what that problem was like.
Как я говорила, что такое система теоретически и как она работает в программировании, я знала еще в 20 лет.
As I told you at the workshop that I'm a programmer and I can build systems for computers. So I knew what is a system, I knew how it works, but I never thought I can apply it in my life.
Но я никогда не думала, что это можно применить к жизни.
Even though I built systems like 20 years ago, I never thought I can apply them in my life.
Not just
in everyday life.
She was just thinking looking at system as technical things, as mechanical things. She never knew that systems could be applied in life to resolve issues, to resolve every sphere of life. That's what she was thinking.
Я думала, что мне достаточно что-то подумать, иметь какие-то мысли, что-то начать делать, и все будет работать.
I thought that it's enough for me to just have some ideas, some thoughts, to start maybe doing here and there, and then everything
no plan,
just...
No organization, no plans, no structure.
Everything just works.
А еще я способная.
And, you know, I'm smart.
А еще умная.
I'm so clever.
И у меня все и так получится.
So everything will work out well for me.
И by itself, you know. Just like that's what you used to think. Are you finished with something like that?
И тратить время на...
Africans are like that. Это африканцы такие.
Так поэтому мне там легко было.
She said, that's why I felt like at home in Africa.
I said, Africans are like that. She said, oh, now I can see why I felt like at home with them. I used to be just like them.
И действительно, я когда была в Нигерии, пастор знает, я себя очень хорошо чувствовала.
When I was in Nigeria, I felt like at home. I felt like fish in the sea.
Мы себя хорошо чувствовали, когда была в Нигерии.
И я думала, что это не нужно. То есть это лишняя трата моего времени.
So I thought that what to build a system for life? It's not necessary. It's just wasting my time. Everything will work like that.
Я никак не могла понять в то, что действительно это 75% успеха ее прописать в систему.
I couldn't realize that 75% of success is actually building a system.
Следующее, я боялась их писать, потому что я не верила в реальность их работы.
Next point, I was quite afraid to build systems because I could not believe that they will work.
И когда пастор задал нам задание построить системы,
so when pastor gave us an assignment to build a system,
я до последнего дня упирала.
I was protesting until the last day.
И
people fought me. You know, my own people also used to fight me.
И когда много из нас в апостольском совете тогда не написали систему.
And quite many of ours didn't do that assignment in time.
И пастор начал общаться с каждым по телефону. Пастор начал звонить каждому по телефону.
And then pastor started to personally call each of us on the phone.
Система.
Мы уже начали между собой общаться.
Then we started to call each other.
Мне пастор звонил, мне пастор.
You know, pastor called me today. Oh, you too.
He also had that problem. He couldn't get it for a long time. So this was my weakest students. These all these teachers, all these who are teaching this way. But now they caught it and they're going on.
Да, тоже.
Я был последний.
He said that was the last one.
И когда мне пастор позвонил,
so when pastor called me,
я говорю, пастор, я не могу ничего написать.
I said, pastor, I cannot build any system.
Потому что это будет только теория.
Because if I build something, that will be only theory. I'm not that kind of person, just telling stories and building theory.
И пастор, а пастор говорит, пиши теорию.
Pastor said, no problem, just write this theory.
Говорит, мне нужна теория.
I do need theory, he said.
Theory.
Theory.
Говорит, мне нужна теория.
I do need theory.
Мне не нужна сейчас, чтобы вы это сделали. Напишите, что вы видите. Напиши, что ты видишь.
I don't need you to apply it right now, today. Just write what you see.
И тогда была цель написать систему.
Write what you understand till now. Just what you get. Just put it down.
И была цель написать систему развития посольства Божьего до миллиона человек.
За пять лет. The assignment pastor gave me is to develop a system of how to multiply the number of the Embassy of God members up to 1 million.
И, ну, я разозлилась на себя.
I was quite angry at myself.
Села и за один день я все написала.
And I said, am I stupid or what? So I just sit down and develop the system for one day.
И думаю, пастор, вы хотите теорию?
I said, okay, pastor, do you need theory? You get it.
Вот вам теория.
Here you go.
Есть теория.
Потом оказалось, что это была самая лучшая система.
And then we realized, at the apostolic council, the pastor said that that system was the best system.
И потом пастор дал задание на основании этой системы разработать систему по всем регионам.
So then pastor gave assignment to each apostolic council member to use her system as a foundation to develop system for each region. You know that every apostle oversees some regions. So all of them had to write their own system for their own regions based on her system.
И я использую, когда я что-то не понимаю, когда я чего-то не понимаю.
When I don't understand something.
Чего пастор от меня хочет?
When I don't understand what pastor expects from me.
И даже если я сопротивляюсь,
even when I protest,
то потом я говорю себе.
So later I tell myself.
Хорошо, пастор, если не хватает моей веры.
Okay, pastor, if my faith is not enough,
пусть работает ваша.
I just trust your faith in me.
Поэтому мне нужно сделать только мою часть.
I just have to do my part.
И потом. Даже не тогда, когда я эту систему писала.
And you know, later, not even when I built that system.
А после того, как мы ее разбирали на апостольском совете.
But after we looked at that system at the apostolic council.
Я только тогда поняла сама, что я написала.
Only later I realized what I wrote.
Поэтому в этом случае, ну, нужно включать послушание.
So just, you know, sometimes we just need to be obedient to our pastor.
Потому что это все в нас заложено.
Because we have everything.
И мы часто не знаем, что у нас есть внутри.
But often we don't even know what we have, but pastor knows and he has faith in us. So if our faith is not enough, just be obedient and do what he says.
Поэтому хорошо иметь человека, который может оказать на тебя правильное давление.
So it's good to have a coach, a person who can put some pressure on you in the right time.
Поэтому я и говорила на семинарах, что не надо ожидать, пока люди будут меняться или захотят меняться.
That's why at our workshops we said that you cannot expect people to come and say, oh, can you help me to change? I want to change.
Нужно планировать его изменения.
You need to plan change for each person. You need to plan improvement for each person.
И вы же делаете это все для Бога.
You do all that for God.
Вы же не делаете насилие на человека.
You don't
you are not abusing.
Yeah, you're not abusing people. You help them to improve.
Вы помогаете человеку измениться к лучшему.
So you help them to change for better, to improve.
Другого пути нет.
There is no other way.
Не надо переходить на учение, а то они уснут.
Все, thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah, they are sending you today.
I want to ask, what is your global purpose for life?
Какая ваша глобальная цель жизненная?
Хороший вопрос.
It's a good question.
Тоже ты написала.
Одним из 10 влиятельных людей в этой стране.
To become one of top 10 influential people in this country.
Most influential.
Most influential people in this country.
В политической сфере.
In the politics.
Достигнуть через свою работу миллиона человек.
Reach 1 million people through my work.
Стать миллионером.
To become a millionaire.
И к 70 годам контролировать деятельность нескольких корпораций.
And by the age of 70 years old to control work of few business corporations.
Написать 10 книг.
Write 10 books.
И заниматься преподавательской деятельностью.
And be a coach, a trainer, teacher.
Can I make an observation?
Pardon?
Can I make an observation?
Ага, он хотел поделиться своими наблюдениями.
That's too small.
Слишком маленькая для вас.
Да? Maybe I will correct it.
We need you all over the world.
Весь мир вас нуждает. Весь мир вас ждет.
Ukraine is so small.
Украина слишком маленькая для вас, Эль.
You need to have a world vision.
Вам нужно пересмотреть свою глобальную жизненную цель.
У меня это на уровне эмоций и желаний.
So it's now maybe on the level of emotions and desires.
Я должна это сначала увидеть.
I have to see it first.
Поэтому я решила, что до сентября я буду подтягивать свой английский.
So what you said is just some of my desires and dreams, but I didn't see it clear first, so that's why I didn't write it down. But I made a decision that by September I will improve my English.
И буду что-то начинать делать, но цель пока не сформирована для мира. Ну это то, что я говорю, что я поняла, общаясь с вами.
And then I'll start doing something in this direction. But that's actually one of the things that I realized while fellowshipping with you, that I realized I have to have something to give to this world. So now you're right, probably I have to rewrite my global purpose of life.
She's going to speak English by September very well, and then she could have a vision for the world.
Vision is first, but then English next.
Видение идет, а потом уже английский.
Да, я знаю, но... Как пастор говорит, у меня есть такая способность быть сельским чемпионом.
Pastor said that I have probably it's one of my weaknesses to be a local champion.
Я могу не верить в свои силы, пока я не увижу, что у меня что-то получается.
I don't believe in myself until I see I can do something.
Конечно, это все делает Бог.
Of course, God does all that.
Но я как Фома, мне надо что-то потрогать.
But I have to touch it first before I believe.
Хотя я была во многих странах.
I visited many countries.
И, ну, я сама не понимаю, почему так.
Когда у тебя не ответ.
Да. Mm-hmm. Спасибо.
She's going to consider that.
Actually, I encourage you to do so because.
Я ободряю вас, чтобы вы пересмотрели и сделали более глобально.
God's vision for you is the whole world.
Ваше видение должно быть для всего мира. Весь мир нуждается в вас.
Thank you.
Я это им уже давно говорил, но.
classes.
Okay, everybody wants to sit? Yeah? Александр, окей, вот это. А я послушаю твое пожелание, что ты?
Нет, тоже самый вопрос для него, по-моему.
Ага, что ты скажешь?
The same question for me about my global vision.
No, how you, how.
Твое впечатление после работы с ним.
Я буду на русском. Я думаю, у меня есть такое очень глубокое понимание.
I have a deep understanding.
Что ту работу, которую пастор сейчас проводит, можно сравнить с ситуацией с Гидеоном.
That the work that pastor does now with us,
is doing.
The pastor is doing now, we can compare to the situation with Gideon.
Израильский народ был в рабстве много лет.
The Jewish nation, they were in slavery for many years.
И Бог говорит освободить народы, освободить народ от рабства.
And then God said to deliver his people from slavery.
И он находит одного Гидеона.
And then he found one Gideon.
Который имел веру, ну, и что это возможно.
Who had a vision, who had faith in this vision.
Это пастор Санди.
And that is Pastor Sunday, that Gideon.
После этого пастор, ну, Гидеон созвал 32 тысячи человек пришло.
So after Gideon got that vision, he called people to join his army.
Я вижу это как, это как история посольства Божьего до кризиса, когда посольство Божье насчитывало около 30, скажем так, условно, больше 30 тысяч прихожан.
And you can, Киеве, да?
You can compare that with the history of the embassy of God. Before crisis we had 30,000 people in Kyiv only.
Как и у Гидеона, армия была 32 тысячи.
As Gideon's army, 32,000.
Глобальное видение, которое Бог дал Гидеону, это освободить страну от рабства.
Global vision that God gave to Gideon is to set his people free.
И когда эти люди пришли, Бог ему говорит: не с этими тебе воевать.
And when those people joined his army, God said, no, you don't need those people to.
Все, кто боятся, у всех, кто уже наделал штаны, могут идти домой.
Those people who are scared, who are afraid, they can just come back home.
И это история посольства Божьего.
That is the history of the embassy.
Когда люди испугались всего, что происходит вокруг посольства, взяли свои вещи и поехали домой.
People, they got scared of the situation going on with the embassy of God, so they just packed their stuff and went back home.
Так и получилось. Осталось 10 тысяч.
So 10,000 left.
Это история посольства. Мы ее видим в протяжении последних трех лет. И после этого Бог говорит Гидеону: и все равно не с этими тебе воевать. Потому что глобальное видение оставалось. Оно никуда не делось. И освободить народ от рабства. И когда он привел его к озеру, ну, к речке, там, к водопою, скажем так.
When Gideon led his soldiers to a stream,
Бог говорит, что вот эти, которые лакают, которые бросили оружие, просто как там собаки, тоже отправляй их домой.
So God said, those people who, as soon as they saw water, they left their weapon and they were drinking like that, so just leave them home, send them back home.
Что происходит? Пастор Сандей, после того, как осталось после кризиса всего, грубо говоря, 10 тысяч человек.
So what is happening? After the crisis, we can say that like 10,000 people left.
Вместо того, чтобы радоваться, что хоть кто-то остался с оружием, ну, хоть кто-то, короче, при деле.
So Pastor Sandy, instead of thanking God that at least somebody stayed.
Он отбирает к себе в домашние группы.
He selected some people into his home groups.
Вот в такие вот тренинговые группы.
And such training groups like you.
Всего лишь 500 человек.
So he only selected 500 people.
Как и у Гидеона, осталось 300.
Like Gideon, he all only remained with 300.
Чем эти 300, или вот как вы, вот часть этой группы, отличалась от остальной толпы прихожан церкви?
So what is the difference between Gideon's 300 soldiers and the other crowd?
You remember, so, you don't can understand why he said he only has 24 people, right?
Yeah.
Они не утратили ведение. Это глобальная цель — спасти народ, ради которой они были призваны. Они его не утратили. Это было отличие от остальных толп, которые просто приходили и тусили в церкви.
Because those people, they didn't lose their vision.
Their initial global vision.
to set their nation free.
Когда я понимаю,
their focus was not at drinking water, their focus was not at the enemy, their focus was not at the temporary and preliminary things around them. They kept their eyes fixed at the global vision.
Я понимаю, вода, которую они пили, это тест на жажду. Когда Бог начал проводить людей и тестировать этих сердца, их, чего они на самом деле жаждут, что в их сердце, что на самом деле у них страсть в сердце, к чему они устремлены, что есть фокус ихнего сердца.
And I see this water, it's like a test from God. What are you really thirsty for? Are you thirsty for your comfort? Are you thirsty for your own interest, or you are thirsty for the things of the Lord?
И это тот тест, который сдавали эти 10 тысяч. И когда жажда к наживе.
They not all of them passed that test.
Жажда заработать денег, построить большие церкви.
And some of our like our people, right? They are thirsty for money. They are thirsty for glory. Yeah, they are thirsty
это
for like,
these
big churches for myself. So that was a period of crisis.
Бог сказал. Выписываем путевку в жизнь, пусть шагают до дома.
So God said, okay, you are free to go and build your big church.
Осталось всего тех, которые в экзамене на страсть были сфокусированы на цели, на видении и на желании исполнить цель, призвание освободить страну от рабства.
So only those people remained who were focused on the initial vision. So they were thirsty not for their own interest, they were thirsty not for something for themselves, but they were thirsty to bring the glory.
Они не бросили это видение ни в какой момент в своей жизни.
They didn't move their focus from the initial initial vision. Even though they were exhausted.
И я понимаю, что они шли несколько дней к воде.
And I realized that they probably spent few days while looking for that
Пастор Сандей имел видение пророческое относительно кризиса, что через 2.5 года этот кризис закончится и придет большое благословение в церковь. И я вижу, что это как процесс, когда Бог вел этих 10 тысяч. Осталось только 300. Вот эти 2.5 года, или как по Библии пример, они пару дней шли.
And Pastor Sandy had a prophetic vision that in 2.5 years this crisis will be over and a huge blessing will come. And I see that you can compare it to those few days while Gideon's army was looking for water.
И я думаю, что мы еще многие из нас в процессе, когда мы идем и когда Бог еще нас проверяет. Это жажда, это страстью, чего мы хотим и насколько мы сфокусированы на видении.
And I see that many of us are still in the process when God is testing us. What do we really want? What are we thirsty for?
Но когда осталось у Гидеона только 300 человек.
When Gideon remained with only 300 people.
Это прообраз того, что осталась небольшая группа людей, с которой пастор реально работает. Их около 500, может быть, 600 человек с перестраховкой.
So you can see the same in Pastor Sandy's life. He has 500, maybe 600 of selected people that he really works with.
Смотрите, они не победили обычными военными хитростями. Они не воевали лоб в лоб. Они не воевали ни какими-то тогда или современными методами ведения войны.
They didn't didn't win with their regular like war strategies.
Ну не просто war strategies. Они не воевали обычными методами ведения войны.
They didn't fight with the regular methods.
Чем они победили? Они победили первое стратегией.
So they won because of number one strategy.
Системой.
System.
Они победили Божьей мудростью, то есть это стало как единая команда с организованной системой мышления.
They won by God's grace also, so God's wisdom also. They became a united team with organized system of thoughts.
Которые не задавали себе вопрос, правильно ли Гидеон делает. Они были в 100% послушании лидеру.
They never asked question, or is Gideon doing right? They were 100% obedient to their.
Это было вопреки всем существующим стилям ведения войны.
They trusted their leader 100%, and actually, what they did was not usual for regular strategy.
Понабирали горшков с огнем и побежали на армию миллион.
So they took their those plates or whatever with fire and they just ran to the enemy.
И я вижу, что это и есть то, что делает Бог. Он отобрал группу людей, которой он дает понимание лидерства, стратегии, система, видение, послушание Богу. И это та армия, которую Бог готовит для того, чтобы исполнить глобальное видение, освободить мир от рабства.
I see that this is exactly what God is doing. So he selected people who have vision, who have passion, who are ready not to look for their own interest, but to just look to glorify God. And this is the best strategy for war.
Я знаю, что в мире существует около 200 стран.
I know that there are about 200 countries in the world.
И я имею откровение на этот счет. Когда в Исаия 43:4 написано, что так как ты дорог мне и многоценен в очах моих, выкуп за тебя я отдам народу и Египет, ну, Савию за душу твою.
And I have a revelation about that. Isaiah says that you are so valuable in my eyes that I will give other nations for you.
И я понимаю, что вот эти 300 человек, они будут иметь в глазах Бога такую ценность, такую стоимость, обученные всему, что каждый из них будет стоить стоимости целого народа. И Бог будет их отдавать в выкуп за народы и за души, за спасение в последнее время.
And I realized that each one of those 300 soldiers or people will be so valuable in God's eyes. God will be able to give the nations for them. They will be equal to the nation. And God will be able to use them to lead nations.
Я понимаю это место Писания, что так как ты дорог, то есть мы становимся настолько ценными сейчас в глазах Бога, что каждый из нас по стоимости будет стоить целые народы.
I understand that scripture because it says that you are so valuable in
so
my eyes, so precious in my eyes, and I know that now each one of us is as precious in God's eyes as the whole nations.
So what for each one of the 200 or 300 people God will give a nation?
Yes.
Because they are so precious.
Вот это и есть та работа, которую Бог производит с вами сейчас.
So that's the work that God is doing on you.
И вы попали в это.
And I think he got it quite right.
Yes.
Can you really say after meeting with them? Can you say it's like each one of them is as precious as a nation, right?
Yes. Yes.
И получается, что
weight of each one of them is.
Вес, который несет каждый из них.
И я думаю, что сейчас мы просто-напросто приобретаем навыки профессиональные в разных сферах, комплектуя или совершенствуя, или создавая как бы единый образ каждому из нас, вот этого вот многоценного человека, оснащенного всеми современными оружиями, ведением этой духовной борьбы, которой Бог готовил тогда армию Гедеона. И когда Бог закончит работать с нами, то, что пастор говорит, следующий уровень, следующий уровень, следующий. Вот тогда начнется настоящее пробуждение. Каждый из вас – это целая страна, которая будет спасаться.
And I think that now we are in the process of getting knowledge in different areas. So we are in the process of preparation now.
Perfection.
Perfection. And after God will finish His work of perfection on each of us, then the real revival will start.
Wow. A pleasure. Very deep, huh? Yeah. Very deep. That is not system anymore, that is revelation. That is no more system, that is revelation.
Yes, yes, yes. That's
cool. The whole story of what?
In two phrases.
In future too.
Yeah, what's the new global purpose for life?
Okay, I can't stand you. Я знаю уже много лет, что моя глобальная цель напрямую связана с Украиной.
For many years already, I know that my global purpose of life is connected to Ukraine.
Моя миссия привести к Богу за при моей жизни, пока я буду жив, 3 миллиона.
My mission is to bring to Christ during my life 3 million people.
но научите подготовить команду, которая после меня еще 50 миллионов приведет.
But to train a team that will bring 50 more million people to Christ after I die.
То есть мое число это 50 миллионов, 10% от ведения пастора.
So my
maybe not after I die, but apart, separate from it.
Okay. My purpose of life to bring 50 million people to Christ is 1/10 of a pastor's global life purpose.
Но я знаю, что моя глобальная цель это политика, большая политика в Украине, и это один из пост руководить, ну, в руководящем составе страны.
I know that my calling is politics. I know that I'm gonna be one of the top political leaders in this country.
Я знаю от Бога не просто это, ну, так, в идее, конкретные годы, сроки, сколько лет надо для того или иного плана, промежуточные цели. То есть вплоть до 2024 года у меня конкретно прописан путь в политику и какие промежуточные цели.
And it's not just a dream. I have a detailed plan written up to 2024. I know what year, what month I'm going
what
to
position.
What position I'm going
и
to
Бог
take.
Мне это
what stage, what position first, what и, year, да. When.
И как минимум 5 разных мест из Писаний, где я просто могу подсчитать по цифрам, сообразить по книгам, и эти годы сходятся. С разными местописаниями мне Бог подтверждал, даже вплоть до того, в какой год что должно происходить в моей
жизни. And God confirmed me with different scriptures exactly year when I will get that or other position.
And it's done it scripturally too.
Поэтому, когда мир ожидает...
Calculated, everything calculated.
Да.
For the detail.
Поэтому это дает мне как, ну, с одной стороны, дает свободу действий, с другой стороны, очень большую ответственность, потому что я ограничен в сроках, и я понимаю, что в какой год, какой результат должен иметь каждый год.
And from one side it gives me a freedom, but from other side it's you know, it's kind of a pressure because I know for sure what year, what position I'm going to take.
What result? What result he has to have each year to get to that ultimate.
И кроме этого, Бог мне показывал, скажем так, не показывал, а говорил мне о моей смерти, о том, когда, в каких обстоятельствах, в каком примерно позиции, ну, придет время идти на нем.
And also God even showed me when and how and in what position, like, yeah,
position
what
in the political.
I am going to finish my earthly.
Поэтому я спешу, поэтому
so God has told me when I'm going to die, how I'm going to live, and all that, when
поэтому,
how many years I have left.
Поэтому я спешу, я пишу много книг, я готовлю команду,
I train my team.
Поэтому я думаю, что есть благодать на то, чтобы думать глубоко, детально, чтобы передавать это.
And I think there is a grace to think deep, detailed, and to teach your team to do the same.
Но я хочу вам сказать, как эта благодать пришла. Пастор говорит, что я один из последних, кто раздуплился, кто въехал в систему.
And I want to share with you how I got this grace. Because as pastor said, I was one of the last students who was able to understand systems.
It was the least in my team. It was the most difficult.
Я никогда не был, ну, туповатым в этом плане. Я понимал некоторые вещи.
I was never a stupid person. I understood some things.
Но когда члены апостольского совета, а особенно Алена Геннадьевна, рисовала системы, я начал понимать, что у меня, короче, не хватает какого-то инструмента, чтобы понять все, что она говорит.
But when apostolic council members and especially Алена Добровольская presented their systems, I realized that something is missing in my life. I cannot really understand those systems.
И когда в апостольском совете начали открываться системы одному, второму, третьему, четвертому, а я сижу и я понимаю реально, что я туплю по-настоящему.
And then, after some time, different apostolic council members started to present their own systems, started to come up with different, unique, wonderful systems. I was sitting there and realized that, come on, I feel so stupid.
И я уже один раз увидел очередную, я там что-то прописал, пастору дал, и надо было защищать эту систему. И я так посмотрел на пастора, и он, видно, понял мое состояние, Он такой посмотрел. Ну да, лакор он сделал. Ну потом посмотрим. Раз так я понял, что. Короче, пастор понял, что если я очередной раз сейчас буду лажать здесь, то мне будет очень нехорошо.
One time we presented our homeworks at the Apostolic Council, and I was about to present my system, if I can say so, if I can call it system. And then I just looked at Pastor, and Pastor looked at me, and he said, okay, Alexander will present his system later. Pastor realized that I will not survive one more failure.
He was not going to be able to survive another failure.
Именно тогда я понял, что пастор не против меня, он за меня.
That time I understood that pastor is not against me, he's for me.
Почему это важно? Почему я вам это говорю?
Why I'm sharing that?
Я был один из очень, ну, скажем так, очень гордым человеком, очень эгоистичным, потому что в жизни я всего добивался сам, я такой интеллигентный грешник. И был немного надменным, и мне казалось, что я один из самых умных вообще в этом апостольском совете. Это правда?
Why I'm sharing that? Because I used to be very egoistic person. I was so proud of myself. I was kind of intelligent sinner. I used to think that.
What sinner?
Intelligent. I used to think that I'm one of the smartest people in the Apostolic Council.
Но когда им начала открываться система.
But when they started to come up with their system.
This guy was stupid.
В общем, этот позор продолжался год.
So that shame lasted for a year.
Бог смирял меня.
God humbled me.
Я не знаю, как пастор Сандей, ну, выдержал все это, потому что я не мог, ну, въехать в это.
I don't know how Pastor Sunday could have and, such patience, could endure all that, and had such patience.
И когда я пришел к выводу, что я не такой уже и умный, как я думал, я начал сидеть и слушать каждого члена апостольского совета, каждую презентацию. До этого я не слушал, я ждал своей презентации.
When I came to the conclusion that I'm not as smart as I used to think. Then I started to listen to every word of presentation of all the Apostolic Council members, because before I didn't listen to them. I was just waiting for my turn to my turn.
И когда я начал слушать, я начал что-то понимать.
When I started to listen to them, I started to understand something.
Система открылась мне в секунду. Пришло время, после очередного апостольского совета, после там беседки, я ехал домой, и я увидел картину. И это было, ну, мгновение, секунда, вдруг мне открылась эта картина. И все то, что я слышал, весь этот год позора и смирения, оно все только раз, и мне стало понятно, в одно мгновение.
And then at some point God just revealed the system to me. So that all that I heard during that year of shame and humbling myself, just at one second, God just revealed the whole system to me. I realized, I understood things that I couldn't understand for a year.
Да. И тогда Бог мне сказал одну очень важную вещь.
Then God told me something very important.
Первое.
Number one.
Система – это откровение.
System is a revelation.
Откровение от Бога.
Revelation from God.
Бог не может доверить это откровение кому угодно.
God cannot trust this revelation to just somebody.
Потому что это оружие для жатвы последнего времени.
Because that's a weapon for the harvest of the last days.
Многие люди.
That is true. That's what I say.
Wow.
Многие. System is the secret. Combined the secret.
No, nothing can withstand it.
For harvest. Not in the last days.
Многие люди этого мира, которым открылась система. Они используют ресурсы для того, чтобы погубить этот мир, для эгоистичных целей.
Some leaders and people of this world who realize the importance and the power of systems, they use this system to like to
destroy.
To destroy.
И Бог сегодня готовит эту армию людей, которым Он лично сам откроет эту систему, но только тем, чье сердце будет без гордости, надменности, высокомерия, чтобы опять применить на себя и подвести Бога в это время.
And today God is preparing the army for the last days to people to whom He will be able to reveal this system. People whom He will be able to trust with those systems, to know that they will use these systems for good, not for bad.
И я понял, что это точно так же, как написано, что Евангелие — это откровение Иисуса Христа. Система — это откровение Иисуса Христа.
So because I realized that as it is written that gospel is a, like a revelation of Jesus Christ, I realized that system is a revelation as well.
Для тела Христова, для этого времени.
For the body of Christ for these days.
Это первое, что мне Бог сказал.
So that was number one, what God told me.
И второе, что Он мне сказал.
And number two.
Пастор Сандей.
Pastor Sunday.
Это Иисус последнего времени.
Is Jesus of the last days.
Он, то есть, я не сумасшедший.
I'm not a crazy person.
Бог конкретно мне сказал, что это не просто идеально, а это модель Иисуса и вообще Иисус нашего времени.
God told me very clear that Pastor Sunday is like ideal model of Jesus of the last days.
Он говорит, я выбрал тебя быть в команде с ним.
God told me I selected you to be in Pastor Sunday's
team. Не пренебрегай этим местом.
Don't neglect this place.
После этого я понял, что я не оценивал по достоинству выбор Божий.
After that, I realized that I didn't value enough God's choice.
Из-за гордости и всего что.
Because of my pride and so on.
И это был очень серьезный, разговор с Богом, после которого я понял, что мне оказано, как и вам всем, честь быть в команде 300 Гидеона, которым доверена миссия нести этот эстафетную палочку и спасение на планете.
And that was a very serious talk with God, after which I realized that God trusted me to carry His vision for the last days in Pastor Sunday's team.
That's enough.
Wow.
Another question. Is Europe going to be one nation? If so, what's the political role then are you going to be playing?
Я понимаю. Я вам когда рисовал видение, да, на 20 лет, на 15 лет, я вам показал только 5 лет, это как церковь. Но в этом глобальном плане я знаю, что Бог призвал меня служить другим народам.
But I know that God called me to minister to other nations as well.
Был период, когда у меня было бремя за Америку.
It was a time when I had burden for America.
Особенно за Атланту.
Especially for Atlanta.
И я много ездил в Атланту, Бог мне показал видение пророческое о том, как Он хочет использовать Атланту.
And I went to Atlanta many times, and God showed me a prophetic vision.
И 3 года подряд я ездил, проповедовал, высвобождал это видение и благословил пастора посольства, который сейчас там начинает работу.
Sharing the vision, and I blessed pastor. We planted church. We planted church, Embassy of God Daughter Church
about
in Atlanta.
About planted church, yeah.
И теперь я вижу огромное количество людей из Атланты, которые ездят сюда.
And now I see so many people from Atlanta coming here.
То есть это пророческое слово, оно работает.
That prophetic word.
И после этого у меня,
Yes. Wow. Atlanta is.
Я могу сказать, что я видел.
Wow.
Я видел, что Атланта — это город хлеба.
Hallelujah.
I saw that Atlanta.
Actually, you are supposed to shout hallelujah if you are. It's like you understood exactly what he said.
Yes.
You did it just in the spirit. You hear now.
Atlanta is the city of bread.
Like Bethlehem.
Я увидел, что точно, это очень четко, я до сих пор это вижу, что точно так же, как Киев, это город миссионеров, город хлеба, который кормит всю Европу. У Атланты есть миссия поднять там точно такое же сильное пробуждение, чтобы быть городом хлеба, который будет кормить всю Латинскую и Северную Америку.
I see it very clear that the same way as God made Kyiv like a city of bread that feeds the whole Europe, God will make Atlanta also city of bread, and you will feed all Latin and North America.
Я видел.
South America, North America.
Я видел, что это как духовные корабли в Атланту. Атланта будет как духовный порт, куда будут приезжать огромные корабли и заправляться этим хлебом и разъезжать по всей Америке, южной и северной.
I saw Atlanta like a spiritual harbor. Harbor. Where ships will come and get bread and then deliver it into all places.
Что это как брат-близнец Киева, только по ту сторону Атлантики.
I saw that Atlanta is like a twin brother of Kyiv, it's just in America.
Wow.
И я вижу, как сейчас именно Атланта является, ну, лидером по количеству людей, которые ездят сюда. И я впервые говорю об этом, даже вот в присутствии пастора, об этом видении, потому что тогда его высвободил на Америку, я говорил об этом, и я почувствовал, что мое бремя ушло, кто-то подхватил его, это бремя, и несет это бремя. И Бог высвободил меня для другой части мира.
And I see that now so many people come from Atlanta. And that time I just shared that vision, I just shared that word that God gave me. And then I felt that the burden left. Like I'm done with that, so I can do other things with like other countries. But that's what God told me.
But they felt that there are some people from Atlanta who caught that vision. So he felt that he just went there to the country to pronounce it and pray. That was his own part of the duty. And he released that word. He felt that some people caught it in the spirit. And as soon as some people caught it in the spirit in Atlanta, the burden shifted from him. And he just left the place. He said some people already have it who are in that Atlanta.
И когда я был в Атланте, у меня была очень в этой же молитве, у меня была очень сильная переживание с Богом, и Бог мне сказал, что вслед за этой работой, которая будет в Атланте, следующая страна, в которую Бог очень сильно начнет поднимать движение, это Канада.
When I was in Atlanta, I had very strong experience with God in the Spirit, and God told me that the next country where God is going to do huge work will be Canada.
Вот, и после этого у меня было очень большое бремя за Дальний Восток.
And I had also a big burden for the Middle East.
Not Middle East.
Not far.
Far East.
Россия, территория возле Китая, Японии, Монголии.
Territory around China, Japan and.
И тоже около 4 лет я ездил туда и постоянно передавал ведение. И сейчас там поднялась очень сильная церковь, школа и социальная работа, которая имеют признание от власти президента, местной власти, и являются, считаются третьей общественной организацией в регионе по влиянию вообще в этой территории. Больше 150 тысяч человек они охватывают свои работы.
And I was coming to those territories for about 4 years, and now God raised so many like churches and organizations, and God is doing just fantastic work there. And
Медведев
нормально.
Все хорошо. Президент. Да, то есть сейчас они работают с правительством, с местным, с президентом страны.
Now they work with the government. Now they work with president of their country. So they are recognized by government.
Считается третьей общественной организацией по влиянию в Хабаровском крае. Это около 150 тысяч человек влияние регулярно в год.
And they are the third, the most influential NGO in that area. They influence 150,000 people per year.
И когда на них наезжает власть, ну, как бы там разные люди, государство защищает их, чтобы...
Им это уже никак не...
Окей. И сейчас я чувствую, что меня Бог ложит на сердце уже Нигерию. Мне хочется много вкладывать в Африку.
And now I feel that God has given me a burden for Nigeria. I really want to invest into Nigeria, into Africa.
Africa in general.
И я видел, когда мне Бог показывал, что... Нигерия, это еще до того, как мы познакомились с профессором Винсентом, до того, как начался этот университет в Африке.
even before I met Professor Vincent, even before Professor started the Institute for
Бог показал мне, что Нигерия это центр пробуждения для всей Африки.
God showed me that Nigeria will be the center for revival for the whole Africa.
It is that it is.
И сейчас это уже происходит.
And now I see it happening.
Поэтому я чувствую, что есть промежутки времени, когда Бог будет использовать меня и для других стран, но моя global vision is political sphere.
So I know that there will be some times when God will use me for different countries by my but my global vision is politics in Ukraine.
Sorry. Yes.
I just want to bear witness with what he said about Atlanta. Because, you know,
that's what I think. Because
God has actually, you know, spoken to me about that.
Бог говорил мне об этом.
And there's a couple from London,
missionaries,
that God told them to relocate from London to Atlanta.
Бог сказал им переехать из Лондона в Атланту.
Because it's going to start a revival in America.
Он сказал, что начнется ревайвал в Атланте, в Америке через Атланту.
I went to Tennessee. So just to bear witness.
Просто я хотел бы свидетельствовать, что Бог, то, что вам Бог сказал, это действительно уже происходит, и Бог мне говорил то же самое.
Я думаю, что только потому, что я отбросил все свои амбиции, все свои планы на жизнь, просто сказал, что вот мой раб, вернее, мой господин, я его раб, и я буду выполнять его ведение. Это было на ретрите пару лет назад. Я понял, что мне не надо никаких своих планов. Все, что говорит Господин, я должен сделать. И только благодаря этому, все то, что имеет этот человек, мой пастор, я могу теперь это чувствовать, видеть и передавать. То есть просто потому, что я стал в его полностью видении, отбросив все свои идеи и амбиции.
You know, everything that I see happening in my life now, I think it's only thanks to the fact that I just left, put aside all my ambitions, all my own plans, all my own, dreams and so on. I just decided to become like a slave, and I see that Pastor Sandy, he's my father, he's my Lord. So I said, I don't want to have any my own plans, my own ideas, my own interests. I just want to obey, and I don't need my own goals. I want to take part of His goals in this earth and just glorify God by bringing it into reality. So, and that's why, because I was able to put aside my own egocentric ambitions, I see those great things happening in my life now. Now what my spiritual father has, I see that God also grants me.
Praise the Lord.
Слава Богу.
It's almost overwhelming.
Когда надо закончить?
Восемь у нас ужин, а до этого я еще книжку почитать.
Но она была перед время, конкретно скажу, когда это закончилось.
Окей, сейчас 6:30. Уже бы пора закончить, да.
Вам надо на время ставить, границу ставить, просто...
I just want to say that we're going to begin to see a pattern emerge. It's becoming difficult and expensive to begin to bring people here. Secondly, I was telling Pastor Sunday there's a need to screen, people that come to Ukraine. Not that we are choosing for him. So we will start offering at least HMT1,
possibly HMT2. Those are people who have really processed that come.
So I see many of them actually. We already, personally, I will talk to you about that. We already have a plan to bring Alexander next year. And Anona, we will have to include you on that.
Мы хотели пригласить Александра в следующем году, и Алена хотела нас тоже пригласить. Готовить, тренировать лидеров, ездить вместе со мной по многим африканским странам и поднимать лидеров не только в Нигерии,
но и в африканских странах.
готовить тех, кто уже готов, подготовлен. Поэтому мы уже начали эту работу. И
следующий раз. And spend 1 week with us.
Now
we can do the same in Europe. Organize a small retreat conference. Announce it to the rest of us. Those that can come will come. The same thing in Canada. You understand? So I think the synergy has already started. And I don't know what we will call our network, but we shouldn't waste time. God said, can a nation be born in one day? Yes. We shouldn't delay this. We should go ahead and set it up and begin to share resources. It's a much more use of their skills. And because there are some of your people that may not come to Ukraine, but they are coming to you, we will help them in great deal. So, Pastor Sonny, I think he wanted me to talk about how we plan to use them in Africa. Not only that, at some point I plan to invite him, because he also has another ministry, Institute of Fatherhood, which he has not even mentioned. Which is, I know in my heart that it's an institute, we need that in Africa, because you can trace every societal problem to failure of fathers.
And so we need that
beyond building systems and whatever. We need to minister to the whole man. So just get ready. I think this is what I'm saying. Get ready, buckle up your seats. Because you won't be traveling.
He's coming also at the, are you bringing him at the African Rise and Shine?
When? Okay, well, it's next year, not this year.
In the May.
He's very busy right now, trying to build up the church. I say that also to say, if you can structure something on a regular basis, I don't know, a national transformation conference in Canada, set up a month where all of us know about it. It's also a good idea for one or two to come and share their testimonies. Just to teach the theory is not enough. There has to be people who have done it. I can say, yes, this works. National conference, maybe in Atlanta, Chicago. I always look for a good excuse to come to the Windy City. So I think if we can do that, I think we'll see God begin to move in a greater way. In other words, get away from just our individual mind, and look at the system to harness all these opportunities. I don't know how that sounds to you.
So the beginning, though, is that you people must conduct your history makers training for your people, for your teams, for everybody. Just like the sister from Belgium has done, and Pastor Leonard has been doing it every month. We must all see ourselves as coaches already and train our people. Then we could now, after our people must have been prepared a little bit, then we could now bring people to do a bigger thing for those who are more ready, and then, you know, expand it and just multiply the effects.